What's up, YouTube? This is Kagome, and I'm here to talk really quick about why a lot of us eat so fast. We all know that eating fast is not good for us, but we do it anyways because a lot of us we just can't help it. And the slower you eat, the less weight you'll gain because your brain has time to get the signal that you're full. But when you're eating really, really fast, you're shoving all the food inside of you before your brain gets the signal to say, "Hey, I'm full. Stop eating." But why are we eating so fast? A lot of us have been trained at an early age to eat fast. And it starts in public school. It starts at public school. When you're in Head Start and things like that, pre-K, you have more time to eat slower. The teachers allow you more time because during the day you're doing less. You're still learning, but you're doing less. When you get to elementary school, your time starts to get cut shorter because they're trying to squeeze a certain amount of learning in your day. And now they've even got these grab-and-go breakfasts. And you pick them up off a tray in the hallway and take them to your classroom because they don't want to cut down on anything, any learning time. And I know once you get in middle school and high school, you get about 30 to 45 minutes to have lunch. Which that includes 30, 45 minutes of the bell ringing, you getting to the cafeteria, lining up, getting your food, sitting down, and then eating. There's been times in high school I know that I've made it through the line and I've only had 5 minutes to eat everything on my tray. So you start to scarf all this food down so that you won't be late for your class. Because your teacher's not going to care that you were not done eating. All she's going to care about is you're tardy for her class. You might get in, you might not. In high school, that's how it works. They might let you in, they might not let you in, depending on who your teacher is. And that's how it is for a lot of people. They learn how to scarf it down, or they skip lunch altogether and learn bad habits about eating portions and things like that. The lunches are all set up good so that they'll be healthy if you eat them, but if you don't eat them, you're not going to be healthy. If you're, shoving them down your throat, you're not going to be healthy. Because throughout your life, you're going to be trained. Every time you sit down, you're going to feel like you need to hurry, or you're going to miss the next thing coming. And it starts there, and I know for me, it got even worse after I got older, after I had my son especially, and he was an infant, and I couldn't sit down and eat without having to pick him up because he was crying. It's like babies can tell when you're about to do something for yourself. You get them down to sleep, and as soon as you pick up the fork to put it in your mouth, they start screaming. So it's like you gotta hurry. And I trained myself to hurry up, shove the food down my throat, so then when he starts crying, I will be finished. And it's like that for a lot of people, a lot of mothers especially. You feel like you don't have enough time in your day. So you start shoving the food into you before you know it, your food is gone and then you're just starting to feel full, you know? And it's crazy that it's that way, but I just wanted you to be aware that in a lot of cases it's not your fault. Some people, they just like to eat, and even if you're full, they're going to try to keep eating. But for a lot of us, it starts early. It does. If you go to your child's school, you'll see that they have these long lines that they have to wait in, and then each child has to get served, and then they have to go find their spot, and then they have to keep from getting in trouble while they eat their lunch and all these things. And if the class gets in trouble before lunchtime, the teacher can hold them for a few minutes before they even take them to the cafeteria. And that cuts down on their time as well. So it's not really your fault, but you have to kind of try to fix it. And my son's in the background, so you might see him. I have decided I was going to try to stop eating so fast. I know that's like one of the pitfalls of my health and my weight losses. I still kind of shove food down my throat. I watch TV when I eat. I talk a lot when I eat, and it's just not good because I'm not paying attention to what's even on my plate. And then, like, I look down and my food is just gone. So I decided I'm going to just start eating in quiet and just slowing down as much as I can and trying to form a new habit. Because they say it only takes 30 days to form a habit. So, gotta break this one. Gotta break this lifelong habit. I'm 30 years old. I have to break this lifelong habit of scarfing down my food and slow down. I saw somewhere where you can eat with your less dominant hand, and that will help you to slow down, which I'm sure it could. It seems like it'll be real aggravating. I'll probably be dropping my food all over the place. So, but really, I'm just really going to try to, from now on, take my time and just slow down, look at my food, take smaller bites, and just be more aware of what I'm doing. And I hope you guys do too. I hope you start to notice things in your life that cause you to eat faster and be more aware and try to change those around. Stop eating in your car while you're driving. Because that's like, I gotta hurry up, you biting these burgers and stuff when you're trying to drive and catch the lights and answer your phone and do all these things while you're eating. And it's just not good. But anyways, I just wanted to give you guys a hit up. If you see your kids at school, or if you notice that you're eating really super fast at home, think about school and how fast you had to eat in school in order to get some food in your system. Think about your lunch break at work and how fast you might have to eat. Or think about sometimes you don't get your snack because something goes wrong during school and they skip snack altogether. I know my son says they have skipped snack before. Think about your kids having to go to other classes and not getting the chance to go with the normal class when it's time to go to lunch. Have been a little bit delayed in time before they can get it, actually get in the line, or before they can eat their mid-morning snack, and being extra hungry by the time lunch comes around, and then feeling like they need to shove the food in your throat because they're starving. Think about all that stuff. Think about how you don't eat your snack in the morning when you need it, and how you skip meals, and then by the time you eat, you're starving, just like your kids might be. Think about all these things, and then try to fit them all together and change them around and do it as best you can. You can't control school. You can't control what the teachers are doing or how fast the lunch lady is moving. But you really, you know, I mean, just sit down and think about when you were in school, if you were a fast eater, when you were in school, how fast did you have to eat before you went to your next class? How fast did you have to get your breakfast? If you got to school later, you only had like a few minutes to get your breakfast if you ate breakfast at school. If you ate breakfast at home and you rode the bus, you probably only had a short time to even eat then because you didn't want to miss the bus, you know? So, I guess this is better for a lot of kids if they're packing their lunch, but everybody cannot do that. You have to go through the lunch line and you have to wait for your food to be served to you. You have to wait to get your table. In high school, you have to wait and find somewhere to sit, you know? Sometimes they're sitting all in the hallways and everything. So just think about that for a minute and try to break the habit. It's going to be hard. I'm going to try to do it. I'm going to try my best to do it anyways. My son does eat a little slower than I do, but a lot of times at school, he does not finish his lunch because he eats slow. And I know he doesn't, even if he says he does, because I've been to lunch with him before at school and seen his plate not get finished. And the teachers will tell you that they eat all their lunch, but they don't. I'll tell you that right now. Okay, but anyway, that's all I wanted to talk about today. I hope you guys have a blessed day and be more aware of the surroundings, your surroundings, and the things that you do in your life. Hey, bye!